Hello everyone, my name is Arian from seeyousoon.ca, and in this video series I'm partnering up with Ontario Southwest Tourism to showcase some of the best small town getaways here in the region. This week I'm wrapping up my time in Oxford County to show you all the things to see, do and eat in the town of Tillsonburg.
Located about a two-hour drive west of Toronto, Tillsonburg is in the southern part of Oxford County. It was settled in 1825 by George Tilson, who established a forge and sawmill in the area. Today, Tillsonburg is filled with small-town charm. From the shopping, dining, and historic heritage, it makes for a relaxing weekend getaway with family and friends.
To help me get around the region, I partnered up with Chevrolet to drive the Chevy Bolt EV, a fully electric vehicle. Started. The first thing on the agenda is to check out the Tillsonburg Farmers Market. It's located right beside the Great Western Railway Station, and here you'll find fresh produce and baked goods.
Right beside the farmers market is the Station Arts Center. This community center is located inside the former Great Western Railway Station and is one of the oldest buildings in Tillsonburg, dating back to 1879. Today, the Station Arts Center showcases art galleries, an artisan gift shop, and provides visitor information. To learn more about the history of Tillsonburg, head to Annandale National Historic Site.
So Annandale House was built between 1880 and 1883 by Edie and Mary Ann Tilson. And Edie was the son of the town's founder, George Tilson. And this was their retirement home. It's styled in the aesthetic art movement, which was popularized by Oscar Wilde. And that means everywhere you look in this house, there is so much detail. So from the doorknobs to the door hinges, stained glass everywhere, ornate carpeting, wallpaper. There's nowhere for your eye to sit that's not really busy and beautiful. Dining room is actually the reason why Annandale House is designated as a National Historic Site. It's the best example of the aesthetic art movement that we have in the country. So most notably is the ceiling, because it's so ornate. It's painted by hand, and it's restored to exactly how it would have looked like at the time that Edie and Mary Ann lived here. So when visitors come to Annandale House, they can book ahead for a guided tour. They can, of course, tour themselves through the museum. There are guidebooks.
Next, spend the afternoon exploring some of the shops in downtown Tillsonburg. Two doors down from the Cup and Cake is Peddler's Key. Here you'll find an array of products neatly arranged throughout the entire two-story heritage home. Products are sourced from around the world and make for a great keepsake for yourself or a special someone. If you're into quilting, then a visit to Cherished Pieces is a must. Located along the main thoroughfare of Broadway, they feature a large selection of fabrics, sewing supplies, and creative inspiration for your next quilting project. And just one block south, you'll find the Anchor Shop, filled with nautical-inspired decor, unique furnishings, and a huge selection of Fusion mineral paint. For those fascinated by cemeteries, head to what the locals call Graveyard Hill, Tillsonburg's pioneer cemetery. It was established in 1838 and closed in 1870. And many of Tillsonburg's earliest settlers, including the founding family, the Tilsons, are buried here. Extensive research has been done on those resting here and can be read at the Annandale National Historic Site. For accommodations, book yourself in for the night at Seven Gables. Tucked away on 5 acres of land, the house was constructed in 1904 and was the home of E.V. Tilson, grandson of George Tilson. The entire interior has undergone a massive restoration, and today guests can enjoy a stay in one of 3 suites, all elegantly decorated and each with their own ensuite washroom. The house is filled with antiques and offers that perfect blend of comfort in a historic setting. After you've settled in at Seven Gables, head to Indigo Lounge for dinner. This organic cafe and eatery is located within a wellness center and specializes in dishes that are organic and chemical-free, using ingredients that are unprocessed and sourced locally. Notable options include their Thai carrot and coconut soup, the vegan root fritters, the taco salad, and the pad thai with the zucchini noodles.
Well, it's day two here in Tillsonburg, and we're going to kick things off with a visit to Coyle's Country Store.
Started in 1899, Coyle's Country Store is a fourth-generation family country store. They made their mark back in the 50s and 60s as the first bulk supplier in the region, and were known for their wide selection of baking supplies. Today, you'll still find products in bulk, along with lots of local products, home decor, and their selection of nuts, all roasted in-house. You'd be hard-pressed to visit Coyle's Country Store without leaving with something tasty. Next, head east to the Tillsonburg Regional Airport, home to the Skyway Cafe. Here you'll find your typical selection of comfort cafe foods, but it's the view that makes this meal an exciting experience as you watch the planes come and go. The Tillsonburg Regional Airport is also home to the Canadian Harvard Aircraft Association. And if you're here on a Tuesday or Saturday, you might just catch a glimpse of these World War II training aircrafts in action. Before heading home, stock up on some fresh produce at Sundown Farms Country Market and choose from local fruits, vegetables, cheeses, and meats. There are also Dutch specialty treats to try and a section dedicated to handmade goods with over 80 vendors represented. And to cap off your weekend in Tillsonburg, take one final country drive and enjoy some quintessential farm life views.
Well, as they say, all good things must come to an end, and that wraps up my time here in Tillsonburg and Oxford County. I've had a really great time exploring the region and getting to learn about the history, particularly here in Tillsonburg. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, and of course, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't yet already. Thank you all so much for watching. We'll see you soon.